Hi, I'm Kevin Mitnick, the Chief Hacking Officer at Noble4, and what I'm going to do is demonstrate how hackers compromise you and your business. So first of all, let me show you this contraption I have here. I'm going to pick it up, and it's three devices. What we have here is a battery pack, we have a device called a Wi-Fi pineapple, and an Android cell phone. Now, the Wi-Fi pineapple is a tool that hackers use and people that do security testing, and it's a device that actually has two radios in it. And what it allows a hacker to do is fool people like you and I, and it could advertise what we call an access point name. And in this particular case, we're going to be the wireless access point AT&T Wi-Fi. Why AT&T Wi-Fi? Because many people will connect to it. In fact, there's lots of different stores that offer AT&T Wi-Fi, and it's absolutely free. And your phone, if you have an iPhone, it will automatically connect to AT&T Wi-Fi. Now, would a hacker have this displayed on a table in a coffee shop or in a restaurant? Absolutely not. What they're going to do is they're going to conceal it in a backpack like this. So they'll just put the devices in the backpack, and they'll just carry it on their arm, or they'll leave it on the table. And, you know, you don't know because it's all wireless. So, over here, we have two computers. The first computer over here is the hacker, okay? And we're going to show how when you log on to your bank account, the hacker is able to get your username and password. Over here, we have the victim computer. And if we go to the victim computer and look at what access point we're connected to, as you can see on the top, we're connected to AT&T Wi-Fi. And the AT&T Wi-Fi is actually this right here. A lot of people ask me, I have a Mac, so that means I'm safe. I'm not running Windows. I can't be compromised. But in this demonstration today, I'm going to show you how a bad guy can compromise your Mac, Windows. It doesn't matter what operating system you're using. So let's go back over here and open up Chrome. A lot of people like using Chrome or Internet Explorer. And we're going to go over to Wells Fargo, which is, you know, a well-known bank in the United States. We're going to click on it. What's going to happen is it's going to, you know, go to the login page. And we're going to go and try to log on to the online bank. So I'm going to go ahead and put in my username, which is Kevin Mitnick. I'm going to put in my password. And we're going to go ahead and click Go. And of course, it didn't work. You know why? I don't have an account at Wells Fargo. But you know what? Let's imagine you did, and you were connected to the hacker's network without even knowing it. The hacker has now stolen a password. So if we go over to the hacker's computer, and you see the word credentials here, we're just going to go ahead and refresh it. And if we scroll down, and why it's like this, it actually steals a keystroke at a time. So there's multiple lines here, and we'll see that the user ID is Kevin Mitnick, and we're able to capture it. If we go down here, we see the password as I love Noble4. So imagine that. You're at a local coffee shop, you're at a restaurant, you're just in the neighborhood, you connect to that open, free, public wireless network, and you don't know it, but the hacker has stolen the username and password to your bank account.